All right, let's get started. Here's a great project to do with ice resin. I stamped this image with a solvent ink, and I'm using Faber-Castell's Pit Pins to color it in. They give a really cool watercolor effect, and as you can see here, I can blend them with my finger because they have a slower dry time. So this is a great way to incorporate some vintage book pages into your work. Here I'm using some galvanized wire, and this is really thick steel wire, and I'm just bending two layers of it together and kind of wrapping it around the edges. And then I'm using a hammer here to hammer it flat. It doesn't need to be super flat, but I just want some flat edges. Now I'm putting my bezel back onto my paper and just trimming around it with scissors to get it to fit, you know, pretty closely. You can trim more at the end. I wanted to add a cute little silhouette number here. So this is one of Ice Resin's silhouettes, and I just painted it with some enamels, ice enamels medium, dipped it in my ice enamels imputer and heat set it. And as I'm heat setting it, I'm dipping it back in, and I did this three times to give it a nice, solid, smooth look. Now we're ready to mix the ice resin. So you're just gonna put equal parts of part A and part B into the little mixing cup. This mixing cup comes in all of our resin kits. And I'm gonna use a sponge. I got a little piece of kitchen sponge, slightly damp, wrung it out, and I'm gonna use that to actually apply the resin to the paper first, once I'm done mixing. So here I'm applying that resin, and then I'm gonna lay my wire bezel right on top, and I'll use the popsicle stick to pour on more resin, and then I'll also use the popsicle stick to add some resin on top of my ice enamels number to seal it. Now, once this has cured overnight, you can use some scissors to trim any extra resin or paper hanging out over the edge, and then you're ready to turn it into a necklace. Thanks for joining me today, and hit that subscribe button at the end of the video so that you can get more video updates from Hydrangea Hippo.